On December 17, 2007, PPP GDP per capita figures for 2005 were dramatically revised. India's fell by 38%. China's fell by 39%. Singapore's grew by 39%. And Congo's soared by 188%. Similarly, on April 29, 2014, the 2011 figures were dramatically revised. India's grew by 33%. China's grew by 21%. Singapore's grew by 20%. And Congo's grew by 32%. What explains these dramatic revisions? The answer lies in the ICP. The International Comparison Program is run by the World Bank, with an alphabet soup of organizations helping out. The ICP's main purpose is to compare price levels across countries. The basic methodology is simple. Gather lots of prices, then crunch the numbers. But of course, it's not that easy. There are plenty of difficulties, both theoretical and practical. In part 1, we mentioned three cost of living indices. These are published once or even twice yearly. In contrast, the ICP is a far rarer bird. Since 1970, there have only been 8 editions of the ICP. The 12-year gap between the 1993 and 2005 rounds is particularly glaring. Long story short, the 1993 ICP was an epic fail. It sparked a crisis, and there were doubts as to whether the program would survive. It would survive, but the next round of the ICP would take place only in 2005. Before the 2005 ICP, price level comparisons were done using crude extrapolations of old data. On December 17, 2007, preliminary results from the 2005 ICP were released. It turned out that, whoops! The old data were badly wrong and had to be dramatically revised. For example, India and China were much pricier and thus much poorer than previously thought. Conversely, Singapore and Congo were much cheaper and thus much richer than previously thought. The revisions were enormous. Overnight, the PPP GDP per capita of 133 countries was revised by an average of 22%. In 54, the revision exceeded 20%. Instead of loudly alerting the world to these dramatic overnight revisions, the World Bank swept them under the rug. The 2007 publication contains scarcely any hint of these dramatic revisions. Only in one short paragraph was it dryly noted that China and India's shares of the world economy had shrunk. Worse still, an accompanying publication asserted that the biggest change was for China. This was an outright falsehood. The 39% change for China was huge. But 24 other countries had bigger changes. Such shenanigans prompted one critic to charge the World Bank with peddling poverty and being no different from a snake oil salesman. I have a more charitable explanation. The World Bank simply messed up. In 2007, the World Bank could argue that the 2005 ICP data were newer, better, and more reliable than older data. It was thus quite the surprise when, on April 29, 2014, it released 2011 ICP results, showing that, oops, the 2005 ICP data were badly wrong. Once again, dramatic revisions had to be made. Overnight, the PPP GDP per capita of 141 countries was revised by an average of 25%. In 60, the revision exceeded 20%. Once again, the World Bank swept it all under the rug. When one think tank pointed out that with the new results, global absolute poverty fell by almost half on Tuesday, they were promptly flamed by the World Bank's former research director. Why does the World Bank repeatedly get it so wrong? What exactly were the errors? These are questions we'll try to address in the next video.
Econ Pow! Econ Cow is a new channel for educational videos, mostly on economics. I'm still trying to improve, so please feel free to leave me any feedback in the comments below. And of course, like, subscribe, and watch another video.